Okay, so today will be the start of a new session. Start of a new session. So what we want to start today is progressing further from our five elements, which is into the 12 animals. Okay, 12 animals, which of course are the basics will be the five elements which all you have lah. Okay, now I'm not going to follow sequence in the book. Okay, the book actually starts off with dragon form. Okay, so if I think if I start with dragon form today, then half of it will be gone next week lah. So I will start off with tiger form this week. Okay, so what I'm planning to do is I will start off with those form that requires one or two maximum movements. So things like tiger form, things like the emu, things like snake, and all this stuff. Things like alligator. Okay, before I progress to other things, for example dragon or even more complicated things like chicken, which requires about 4 or 5 steps, and your hawk and all this stuff, which also requires about 4 or 5 steps, and maybe lastly I'll conclude with monkey form, which is the rather the most complicated ones. Okay, so today what I want to start off with is tiger. Okay, generally if you read Sun Lu Tang book, you notice that the first two animals starts off with dragon and tiger, and dragon and tiger actually represents two different type of qi flow in the body. So sometimes we call these two type of qi flow long hu er qi, or these two type of qi flow. So one of the flow focuses on the ren mai, the other focuses on the tu mai, which is your meridian lah. Okay, so what we want to do today is the tiger form. Now tiger form itself, right, when we go into the form, right, what we want to bring out in the 12 animals that we did not bring out in the five elements are two things. Okay, number one is the animal's characteristics. Okay, animal's characteristics. Okay, by animal characteristics, I'm talking about what an animal should be doing if you are, say, tiger. Okay, how should a tiger behave? Okay, how should a tiger behave? No doubt the fact that when you do the routine itself, right, it is a pao quan look-alike routine because the movement is zigzag. Okay, but the difference is within the characteristic of the animal. Okay, that's number one. Okay, then number two is bringing out the instinct of an animal. It's two different things. How an animal behaves and how an animal will react. That's two different things. Okay, so animal generally, how do they behave? And when danger is posed, how do you react? So two things that we want to talk about. And for tiger itself, right? Now, tiger itself, there are two things inside this form that we want to talk about. Same thing also, talk about instinct, talk about reaction, all this stuff. So the first thing that you imagine a tiger, sometimes we say tiger stays in a cave, right? Okay, to the 洞里面. So the first thing that happens is if you disturb the tiger, what's the reaction of the tiger? Roar, tiger won't roar you and not so fast. What's the first thing a tiger? The tiger is not lion, it will roar. It will look at you. You notice cats, right? Felines, right? Sometimes those small cats. You walk by, the first thing you do is like look at you. Same thing. Okay, same thing. So we want to bring out this type of characteristic of the tiger later on as we move. Okay, turn. And then once the tiger lock you on, right? What's the next thing a tiger will do?
Lunge is ready.
Pound on you. Okay, so we want to bring out these two things today. Okay. Instinct, look at you, turn, coming out of the cave, then pound on the prey. Okay, these two things. Okay, so let me talk, let me show you first how does the tiger form look at one or two movements, then we talk about details like how we do every time. Okay, so we go with san ti shi as usual. Okay, san ti shi as usual. Okay. At the very beginning, it starts off with things that looks like a pao quan. Okay. Something like this. Okay, something like this. Okay, so let me talk a bit about the details first. Okay, you notice as we start off, it is exactly like pao quan. Okay, so maintain it that way. Okay, maintain it that way. So when we start off with pao quan, do recall that what we want to do is first we make a step to the side. Okay, then the other hand comes up and then bring in. Correct? This is how we start with pao quan, then after we do pao quan. Okay, so same idea. Okay, same idea. except that the hand itself, right, is slightly downwards. What do I mean? If you take note of Pao Quan, right, I'm going to do comparison now. If you take note of Pao Quan, right, you notice that I move forward, this hand goes straight, then turn. Okay, this is Pao Quan. Okay, but when you are doing a tiger form, right, what you want to do is to claw your way in. Okay, claw your way in. What do I mean? As you move, instead of going up to a chest level, I move at 45 degrees downwards. Okay, hand this way. Okay, hand this way. Then what I do is I claw in. Lock. Okay, until here it looks very similar. Okay, in fact it's the same. Okay, just that the way that you do is go in, claw. Can you here? Okay, talking about the hand first now. Right. 1, 2. Make sure this two hand lock in. Here. Okay, no need to touch the hand. Just open up. Yeah, open up. Like that. Stick to a side here. Okay, so I do a complete one. I do here. Now you can see. Okay, so here. So 1. So when this leg comes in, the other leg comes in and land together. Exactly how you do for your Pao Quan. Okay? Don't do this. This one become Mao, not tiger. Don't do this. So come together. This is the chicken. Okay, almost like a chicken leg. So go in. Cool. Okay, Ken? 第一招, question? Okay, question? Okay. No question, I continue the second. First, then we practice these two things first together. Then we'll talk about it, other things later. Okay? So once you come in, what's the first thing to do? Remember, just now we talked about bringing out the animal's characteristic and instinct. Okay? The first thing that you want to move is to move to the left, exactly like how you do for your Pao Quan and your Heng Quan. So as you move up, the first thing that you need to do is to show awareness of the environment. Okay? You watch my eyes. Watch my eyes. Okay, so there is an instinct. First, bring out that instinct. Okay, bring out that instinct. Show let yourself know. Let yourself have the awareness that there is something, whatever that thing is, at the side. Okay, one more time. Here. Okay, do animal form, you must bring out this. If not, your animal form is nothing on. Okay, one more time. How about? Okay? Okay, so once this is done, okay, then let me talk about the details of the hand. Okay, once you are here, right, okay, the leg itself, same as your Pao Quan, no difference. So I go to the side, bam, bam, same. Pao Quan, same. Okay, the hand movements, it is similar to a Pi Quan. Okay, similar to a Pi Quan. So in terms of the hand movements, right, what you want to do is you're moving here. Remember when we do Pi Quan, right, we always, our hand, our Quan Xing always point outwards. Then we go up, right, then we Pi, right. Okay, so very similar. So what we want to do is from here, we bring up. Okay, but when you bring up, you don't bring up outwards. You bring upwards directly. Okay, along your ribs. You bring up upwards. Have a double zhuan quan, so there is a zhuan force that goes up. Okay, so pry open. Okay, zhuan force that goes up. So zhuan force that goes up. Okay, until almost reach your chin. Okay, this is how you do zhuan quan, right? Remember? Okay, so almost until your chin. Open up the hand. Okay, then flip. And push up. And push up. Okay, one more time. So here, 1, 2, 3. Okay, now movement is like this. Okay, movement. So 1, 2, 3. Okay, remember the movement first. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, one more time. 1, 2, 3. Okay, details. Okay, now you know when we do pao, our pi quan, right, our elbow is aligned downwards, recall this. Okay, but when you do hu xing, this elbow is not exactly downwards, it's slightly outwards. Okay, slightly outwards. You know why? Any idea? If you do both hands, can you see the pry open of the middle part? So you want this one. Okay, so it's not a mere da like that. When I open direct, so there's a direct force, but there's also a outward force here. Huh? So open and this way, so pai kai. This is not my primary force, this is my secondary force. It's still here, but you must have this open up. That's why you look at Sun Lu Tang's picture, right? You notice that his fuxing is not like this. His fuxing is like this, pry open one. Okay, and at the same time, while you pry open, okay, recall these two portions, you must suck in. Correct, 两肩两胯 must suck in. Exactly how we do our 三体式. So as I move forward, open up, as I move forward, make sure that your these two points at the shoulder suck in. Okay, so when my hand goes out, it's not a mere matter of hand movement. It's not this is muscle power. Okay, muscle power. Your muscle power can only bring you that far. What you need to do is you must have your body motion, this type of body motion, okay, which you all do in your Lohan Kong, right? So this type of body motion. So when I move up, it's pry open and suck in at the same time, your back open up, the scapula open up. Then you have the praying motion. Pray on the pray lah. I mean going down. Okay. Like that. Okay. Now, 1, 2. So when I push out, it's always the back. Okay. 1, 2. Okay. Now, key note, lock your back. Okay. Don't pound too high. Don't become like that. Pushing. Okay. Lock your back. You are only moving this way. You're not moving this way. Different story. Okay. 不要上下移动. Okay. 不要上下移动. You're moving this way. Not like that. So at the end of the day, when your hand goes out, this part is open. Okay? And this is in Sun Shi, we call this Kou Xiong. Okay, Kou Xiong. Those of you who have done Tai Chi will know it's exactly the same thing as the Kai He Shou. Okay? Exactly the same thing as your San Ti Shi. Kou Xiong. My sauce.
Push in.
Suck in. Yeah, actually to say it's suck in, not so accurate. It's actually your hand go out, so this one seemingly suck in. I cannot be like that, right? And then different story, ma. Okay, so it should be here. And move forward. Can feel, yeah. If this is muscular power, it becomes like that. Okay, yeah. Like that. 用后面的 back, okay. So even though I'm doing this, right, you notice that as this hand comes up and I pound forward, there is a cross force. Notice, like that, right? People thought it's like that, right? Actually, when your force comes in, there is a cross force. So when there's a cross, you bounce out, physics, right? You understand what I mean?
It's straightforward, right?
Okay, it's actually like that. I let you feel, in another manner, okay. This is straightforward force. Yeah, thank you. Okay, this is straightforward force. Okay, this is cross force. When I cross, right, the force go here. You see? Yeah, you know what I mean? So when you go in, this is actually a cross force. So your hand bring up, there is a cross force. So go inwards this way. That's why when the hu xing come up, it goes in one impact, not two hand impact. It's one impact. That's the idea. Cross inwards. So it uses your back to move. See my hand not moving. Okay, So once you come up, okay, one more time, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 and
oh, nah.
Okay, okay, okay. So I do from the beginning, and you hear one more time, then we will practice, okay. The last thing I want to talk about before we continue is once you have your eyes here, right? The next thing you want to do is to visualize yourself as the tiger. Fa dou yao la, hungry la. Oh, hungry, I haven't eaten dinner, right? Ah, this type of force. Ah, okay. The haven't eat dinner type of force. Ah, haven't eat dinner type of force. Okay. You're hungry, you're desperate. You want to eat, that's all my good go for. Okay, so that's how you bring out the animalistic nature of tiger pounding. Then after that you go and do whatever you need with the prey.